We recently released a video about scientific materialism in which we showed that it's actually a dogmatic belief system that can never reach the fundamental nature of reality. We absolutely stand by this statement, but reading through the comments and responses, it's clear that a large number of you have completely misunderstood our points. So, we're going to clarify some of the major misunderstandings right now. Now, we don't have time to address every misunderstanding in a single video, but we'll get to them in a future release. For now, let's address a couple of the major ones. Let's begin by being absolutely clear that we are not against all science, we are against bad science. We are for scientific rationalism, while we are opposed to empiricist scientific materialism. We are opposed to it because it's incomplete. Scientific materialism is the current prevailing paradigm, and when the average person thinks of science, they are almost always thinking about scientific materialism. When we say that we're against scientific materialism, that doesn't mean that we don't think it's useful or that it's given us many great advancements. It has. I'm filming a video right now due to the advancements of scientific materialism. Great. What we mean is that it's incomplete, that it contains fundamental ontological and epistemological errors, and due to its incompletion, it cannot get to the underlying non-physical aspect of reality. Now, scientific materialism states that ultimately everything in existence is composed of matter or is a result of matter. Now, this is blatantly false. The materialist worldview has failed. It cannot account for the effects of quantum mechanics. The world at large simply has not realized this, and they're stuck in the mindset of a failed, outdated paradigm. You do not live in a material universe. I want you to listen very closely to these quotes by some of the founders of quantum mechanics. Heisenberg is famous for the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, and in 1932 he won the Nobel Prize in Physics for the creation of quantum mechanics. Heisenberg said, "The ontology of materialism rested upon the illusion that the kind of existence, the direct actuality of the world around us, can be extrapolated into the atomic range. This extrapolation, however, is impossible. Atoms are not things." Max Planck, a pioneer of quantum mechanics, famous for Planck's constant, and whose discovery of quantization of energy won him the Nobel Prize in 1918, said, "As a man who has devoted his whole life to the most clear-headed science, to the study of matter, I can tell you as a result of my research about atoms this much. There is no matter as such." The idea of matter, as classically conceptualized, is false. This world needs to wake up, pay attention, and get out of the dark ages. Another huge misunderstanding is about classical mechanics. Classical mechanics is 100% false and has been replaced by quantum mechanics. This does not mean that classical mechanics isn't useful. Again, I'm using a camera right now that was created through the use of classical mechanics. You can use classical mechanics to get a person on the moon. However, classical mechanics is only an approximation. For example, the wave characteristics of everyday objects are not apparent because their high mass gives them an incredibly small de Broglie wavelength. At the scale of reality that classical mechanics is applicable to, the effects of quantum mechanics are negligible and you can effectively ignore them for practical purposes. So in actuality, classical mechanics is only an approximation. It ignores quantum effects for practical purposes. Now, this will be said explicitly in the introduction of any halfway decent quantum mechanics textbook. The fact that some people are objecting to our point here, in comments and in videos, shows that they have no understanding of physics. All they have to do is go to chapter 1 in any decent quantum mechanics book. It's right there. But they've obviously never opened one. Classical mechanics was once considered to be true, but it's now known to be nothing but an approximation and has been replaced by quantum mechanics. and soon a paradigm shift will occur, and the current interpretations of quantum mechanics will also be shown to be an approximation, and they will be replaced by the Hyperion system of ontological mathematics. Quantum mechanics has shattered the idea that reality is material. The world at large needs to catch up and understand this. Stop right now, look around you, and realize that this world is not material. Nothing is what it seems. And this directly impacts your life, because if you look and if you pay attention, you can understand what this reality truly is. Quantum mechanics brought with it a variety of previously unknown effects, such as the quantization of energy, wave-particle duality, and quantum entanglement. Quantum physicists have been unable to understand these phenomena because they can't think outside of the materialist worldview they have been conditioned to dogmatically believe. These quantum effects are incompatible with the materialist worldview. But since scientific materialists refuse to think outside of their worldview, they cannot and will never be able to account for these effects. Scientific materialism is great for making material advancements in the world. They can come up with medicines and iPhones and computer systems, and that's great. It works very well in a practical sense. But as long as it adopts a material ideology, it will never be able to answer what reality truly is in itself, precisely because reality is not material. To answer the big questions of existence, science doesn't have to do anything crazy. It doesn't have to believe in the ludicrous concept of a creator god, or miracles, or any nonsense. All scientific materialism has to do is embrace a rationalist mathematical system. It'll be able to answer all the questions that quantum mechanics brought up and to understand the fundamental nature of reality if it simply becomes scientific rationalism. Right now, scientific materialism simply treats mathematics as another kind of tool, whereas scientific rationalism understands that mathematics is not just some kind of tool, but that it's the real, necessary, fundamental nature of our reality. Scientific rationalism discards the outdated idea of matter and replaces it with a mathematical system. It sees past the illusory nature of the human senses and into the mathematical reality that underpins existence. You don't have to believe that this reality exists. You can know it. It is deductively certain and rationally provable by the principle of sufficient reason. This is not a material reality. This is a mathematical reality. It is a living system of information. To put it another way, this is a reality of mind. But mind isn't just some ill-defined word. What mind actually is mathematical frequency. More specifically, sine and cosine waves. These mathematical sine and cosines, which define mind, underlie all of reality. The waves aren't made out of anything material. They are immaterial, their pure relation, their mind, but they are precisely and analytically defined mathematically. In fact, the governing equation for these sinusoidal waves is Euler's formula, the mind equation, and this one equation can account for everything in existence. In scientific rationalism, reality is composed of nothing but sine and cosine waves, all governed by Euler's formula. And we'll show you how this gives rise to the existence that you're experiencing right now. But first, you have to know a little bit about Fourier mathematics. Fourier mathematics shows that by combining nothing but sine and cosine waves, you can represent any physically realizable waveform. So, any physically realizable wave structure can be broken down into nothing but sines and cosines. They're the building blocks of reality. So, for example, your body is a specific and unique combination of sinusoidal waveforms. Now let's go a little further. A Fourier transform is a mathematical operation that transforms a function of space or time into pure frequency information. And an inverse Fourier transform does the exact opposite. It takes pure frequency information and transforms it into a function of space or time. You can have all the information in existence, all of it, existing together in a single infinitesimal point of pure dimensionless frequency information. This is the singularity. It is the zeroth dimension. It's immaterial and unextended. It doesn't take up any space. All the information of reality is contained within a single point. It's a domain of pure mind, and it contains all the information in existence within itself. But remember that through Fourier mathematics, this frequency information can be represented as a function of space or time. This means that this dimensionless frequency information that is contained within a single point has a space-time representation. So, this reality of space-time that you're experiencing right now is a Fourier space-time projection of pure frequency information. The domain of space-time is a mathematical projection. You can think of it being similar to a computer simulation, a dream, or a hologram. You, as a mathematical function, are immersed in frequency information, but your physical senses perform an inverse Fourier transform, which converts the frequency information into its space-time representation, which allows you to experience the domain of space-time as you are right now. So the cup in front of you is not made of hard bits of matter. It's pure mathematical frequency information that your physical senses convert into its space-time representation through an inverse Fourier transform, and you experience that transformed information as the cup in front of you. Now, if this seems like a lot of information, that's okay. Our system is vast and complex, but we're releasing the details video by video and in other material. There is nothing more important than understanding this information, because it shows that everything you've been told about the nature of existence is completely wrong. This means that you yourself are not what you think you are. The answer to existence is not impossible to know, or even somewhere down the road. You can know it right now. There is so much more than what's been said in this video. We are bringing this information to light now so that rational individuals of this world can come to know what existence is and what they are. My name is Morgue, herald of the new Hyperion Age. Ad Astra, to the stars. Make sure that you like and subscribe and check out my Patreon for hidden videos.
Mathematics was not invented. The particular symbols that we use, yeah, someone came up with the particular symbols, but the underlying mathematical nature of reality is not invented. It is discovered. It always exists. It has always existed. It will always exist. The Pythagorean theorem.
If you enjoy my work, then join us on Patreon. Your support is what allows us to move forward and to get this information out there. And I want to say thank you to everyone on Patreon. It's time this world gets a healthy dose of reason, and you're helping make that happen.